My name is Jason. I'm from Gainesboro, Tennessee, which is in Middle Tennessee, right outside of Cookeville. I've been wrapped up in drug abuse, using drugs recreationally, as well as bound in addiction for several years since my early youth. I lived a double life for a lot of years, where I was lying to my wife and lying to myself and lying to my kids, as I would act one way at work and when I left the house, and I would act another way when I got back home. I was able to wear these two faces for a long time. I thought I was doing pretty well at it, but I obviously wasn't, resulting in being exposed later on, which in a lot of ways was something I was very scared of, you know, from happening, but it ended up being one of the best things ever, because the shame and guilt that was building up inside of me from living this lie and having all this shame and guilt inside me was unbearable. So when the secret came out, it was terrible, yet refreshing to get off of my chest and get out in the open. My wife did give me every chance in the world to patch things up and give me every opportunity to do right and reconcile the marriage, but the addiction just had a hold of me. I was trying on my own strength, and it finally came to the point where I did lose my wife and my family. And then at that point, when that happened, that's when I went over the edge with it. And I, you know, started digging my hole even deeper and went further and further down. I got into a lot of legal trouble, got a lot of drug charges. I caught my first felony charges for drugs when I was in my 40s. And then spun out of control, where I ended up landing an 8-year jail sentence, prison sentence. By the grace of God, I was offered an opportunity to come to Teen Challenge. That started by my ex-wife came to visit me in jail, and she told me about my 12-year-old had said something to her at church that day. It was a Sunday at visitation. So I said, what did he say? So she said, well, after church, he came up to me and said, you know, I wish Dad could go somewhere for a while so he could get better, so we could have him back forever. And then at that point, I fell down and started crying and sobbing right there in jail. And that was the night that I started writing Teen Challenge. She had told me about Teen Challenge, so I started writing Houston Jared, the recruiting director there in Middle Tennessee. I started writing him, and that's where the journey started. I was accepted to Teen Challenge and got the opportunity to come. Since coming to Teen Challenge, when I first arrived, within the first month of being here, I was reading my Bible, and I came across the verse in Philemon 15 that said, perhaps he will be gone for you for a little while so you can have him back forever. And that was basically word for word what my son had said to my ex-wife. So right then and there, I knew for sure that God had placed me here, that I was at the right place. Super excited, super eager to see what he was going to do for me. Since then, he's been restoring my relationship with my family. My mother and I had a broken relationship since then. She recently, a few months ago, flew from Florida and to visit me just for like 5 or 6 hours in Clarksville. He's been restoring that relationship. My kids came all the way 5 hours away from Middle Tennessee just to spend 2 hours with me for our Christmas party. You know, it's just amazing all the exciting and encouraging things that he's doing in my life, the relationships he's restoring, just the way that I feel. I've got a positive outlook on life now. Since giving my life to God, he's taken the shame and guilt away from me. I don't carry that anymore. I truly claim the verse saying that I am a new creation in Christ. And I'm not worrying about what used to happen. I'm worrying about what's going to happen and what I can do going forward. While I was married, we did a lot of traveling and everything. And after I got my felonies, I was a little discouraged that I wasn't going to get to travel anymore, and thought, you know, that my days of traveling abroad was over. Then the missions trip opportunity came up. I applied for the passport, not thinking I was going to get it because I do have drug charges. Throughout a long process and praying about it and everything, my passport ended up getting to be approved, and I did get an opportunity to go on this missions trip to Costa Rica. Something that sticks out in my mind from the missions trip in Costa Rica, our missions trip in this particular missions trip was a little different than a lot of the missions trips that people take here at Teen Challenge. We went on a trip to basically to serve, not to so much give testimonies, but more to work. So the group that went down there, I feel like that God did choose the right group of men to go. We went knowing that we weren't going to get a lot of time to share the gospel with others or the word or our stories, but we were going to work together, and we were going to show them by the way we worked, by the way how we got along with each other, to let them know that we were different, to let them know that we were set apart. And we allowed that our work experience and the way we worked to be our ministry to others. And we all got along well the whole week. We got a lot accomplished. we were able to work on a missionary training center, and we were able to tear down a four-story stairwell and remodel it and rebuild it basically. Did a lot of projects that's gonna be there for years to come. So that's not only gonna make a difference for the missionaries living there now, but it's gonna make a difference for missionaries there to come in several years. And then those missionaries are gonna go out and spread the gospel to so many more people. So the impact that we made might not have been immediate per se in getting to tell our stories, but it was very immediate and future lasting and long lasting on what it's going to accomplish. Going on this mission trip, I would say to basically describe it as briefly as I can, is it's basically going and serving others instead of serving yourself, to bless others as well as be blessed back in the process. And it was definitely a refreshing, encouraging, and life-changing experience.